you see, I love that cross where the nearest blessed in a world of sinners was slain. Now put your hands up as high as you can and say how. Sing that second verse, which I will not do because I don't know it. I'm going to tell you this tonight. The cross had one that went back this way. Yeah. And it had one of the uprights that went back that way. Going all the way back to Adam, one of the preachers said, I don't know whether he was right or wrong. He said nearly 100 million people have lived and died since Adam. But every one of those Old Testament saints died under the blood of Jesus Christ. The Bible said, searching water, what manner of time? The Spirit of Christ, which was in them, when it testified of the sufferings of Christ and the glory that was to come. The prophet saw. The prophet saw the cross. They believed in the cross. They saw the cross. We stand here tonight 2,000 years ago. We stand here removed 2,000 years. How many still see the cross tonight? Put your hands up and say, I see the cross. I see the cross. I'm going to ask you to get out of that chair tonight where you are. And if you need anything from God tonight, the atonement, the process, the sacrificial sacrifice of all humanity hung on that cross. There'll never be a lamb that'll die for you. There'll never be a bullock that will ever die for you. There'll never be an animal that's good enough, spotless enough, holy enough to cleanse your sins. But there was one. And the Bible said he was a lamb slain from the foundation of the world, and that lamb was the Father's lamb. Isaiah chapter 16 says, send you the lamb to the rulers of the people. God had a lamb and he sent it to the rulers of the people. God has a lamb tonight and he's sending it to you. Glory. I've never felt any more anointing in this place than I feel here tonight. And yes, this church is in a transition. This church is going on with God. And America needs not a seeker-friendly church. Nope. America don't need a more silent gospel. America doesn't need a new wagon to put it on. We need to talk about the thing that worked 2,000 years ago, the cross. Everybody say the cross. Will you get out of that chair tonight as I finish this? And if you need anything, I want you to come. I want you to come out of those seats tonight. Every place, this place is filled to capacity tonight. And I like what Brother Joel said tonight. You can't disguise your heart. You can put on the fanciest suit and smile like some actor on a stage. But if your heart is black tonight, you can't hide your heart. That's one. There's others. There are others. There are people here tonight. I looked out across the crowd. Sister Kelly, the Lord's got something special for you. Yes, you. Come. Amen. They're coming. I want you to come. I want you to just gather, and it doesn't matter, just gather around all this place. This place ought to be full of people wanting an answer for your soul. This place ought to be full tonight. Before we leave here tonight, if you're in the back of the house tonight, come. If you're in the front, come. If you're in the van tonight, up here, any of the brethren, our heart must be right. How many need a heart surgery tonight? How many need God to do something in your heart tonight? He can do it. He can do it. Come now.
Yes.